Hi everyone. Today is our fifth day in Java course. Last 3 days we are typing code. Today we will learn nested if statement and then we will learn switch statement. If the time is enough, maybe we will start to ternary statement. Could you please create a package for today? As you know, to create a package, we are selecting Java on the left, select Java folder, and then click on right button of the mouse, new and package. Do that one, please. After selecting package, it will ask you the package name. Make it day 04. Use all lower cases, day 04, nested if switch. This is the package name. Thank you, Mr. Mehmet. I am not counting the practice sessions, Mr. Ömer. Those are instruction sessions. You can create another folder or another package for the practice sessions. It will be better. Okay. After creating package, make it selected again. Click on right button of the mouse, new Java class. Do it, please. First class name will be about if statement. I will solve a question to remind you if, else if, else if, and then we will learn nested if. Make it if statement 01. Okay. This is the class name. As you see, I have a class. Its name is if statement 01. Package name is that one. As you remember, after creating class, we will create main method in it. If you want, you may type main method manually. If you want, you can use shortcuts. Shortcut is PSVM. And then press enter. This is our main method. Without having main method, you cannot run any program in Java. Archetype, no need to select any archetype, Bera. Just select Java, click on right button of the mouse, new and package. You will have just that window. It doesn't ask you any archetype. I am repeating, Bera. Please select Java folder. Select Java folder. Click on right button of the mouse, new and package. Select package. Mr. Mehmet can help you. Okay, everyone. We will do a task. Our task is that one. Copy and paste it, please. Type a code. We will get the age from the user and we will decide which stage on it. For example, 0 from 4 will be baby, 5 from 12 will be child, 13 to 20 will be teenager, from 21 to 30 will be adult. Okay. Otherwise, we will put not expected age. Okay. This is our task. Okay. To get data from user, everyone knows we have to use scanner class. Let us type scanner. It is complaining because we didn't import it. When you wait a little bit on scanner class name, it will give you option, click on import class. As you see, scanner class was imported from Java util library. It's okay. I will put a name for the scanner object input, and then I will use new keyword to create the object from scratch, and then I will type constructor. Class name with parentheses is constructor. Some constructors can work without using any parameter, but some constructors need parameters. Scanner class constructor needs parameter. You will type over here system.in. Why are we typing system.in? Because I will get data from outside and put it inside the code. I am telling system.in. After typing that one, I should give a message to user by using system.out.println. I will tell enter your age. When user saw that message, he will understand he should enter his age. As you know, in daily life, ages are in integer. Because of that, I will create an integer container. I will name it as age equals to, by using input object, I will access to the methods. Can you see next int methods? Why am I using next int? Because age is integer. If you want to get integer from user, you have to use next int. Okay. This is for getting data from user. Yes, Amine says, let us use byte about it. It is okay, Amine. Perfect. Let us make it byte to save memory. Can you see? When I change data type to byte, it is complaining. Why? Because for byte, you have to use next byte method. Next byte selected. Otherwise, it complains. No, Oğuzhan. User will give me a data like 13, like 20, like 30. They are okay for bytes as well. Do you remember? Byte is narrower than int. Actually, byte is in integer, Oğuzhan. For example, I am in Miami. If I tell you I am in Miami, you will understand I am in the United States. It has implicit meaning in it. When I make it byte, it will be int as well. Okay, now I will create if else if statements. Type if, and then it says if the age is between 0 and 4, make it baby. What will I type over here? Pay attention. I will tell to user age is less than or equal to 4. This is true. If the age is 4 or 3 or 2 or 1 or 0, my code will print baby. But pay attention, everyone. Pay attention. This is user. When you ask user to enter his name, he may enter some negative values as well. Negative 2, negative 5. But for negative numbers, if you print baby, it will be a problem. Because negative values are not valid for age. Because of that, I will put over here one more if. Okay. I will tell if age is less than 0, it means if age is negative, I will print invalid age. Okay. I will print invalid age. If age is less than 0, that one will be printed. Else, I will put else over here. If age is less than 0, Java will print that message. If age is less than 4, it will print baby. Mevlüt says, cannot we use and inside the parentheses? Mevlüt, do you remember I told you, make inside the parentheses as possible as simple. Do you remember that one? Okay. To make inside the parentheses simple, I put negative values over here. I put 0, 4 over here. One more reason, David, one more reason. If I use your syntax, Java will tell nothing for negative values. But over here, I am giving a message to the user about negative values. User will understand, oh, that application is perfect. When I make a mistake, it is giving me notification. This is good. Okay. Okay. And then I will type over here, else if age is less than or equal to 12. Can you see? It will print child. And then else if less than or equal to 20, less than or equal to 20, Tuba, maybe you didn't create main method. Maybe you are typing your codes outside the main method. Your code should be between that two highlighted curly braces. Can you see? Check it, please. All the codes should be typed inside the main method. Okay, for less than 20, it will print adult or teenager. Teenager. One more. It will print adult. What is the condition? If it is less than 30. No, Isa, you should put age over here. Okay, it is adult. It says otherwise not expected age. What does it mean? That code is not working for the age more than 30. How will I type it? I will tell else. System out println not expected age. Okay. Someone's are sending messages through Zoom. Please don't use Zoom. Use Slack. Okay. It will give error. Please type that code and then we will test our code with different scenarios. I will not share. Please try to type it. Because you should learn how to type if statements. When I run the code, it will ask me the age. It says, enter your age. Okay. I will enter negative value. For example, negative 3. I am pressing enter. Can you see? For the negative values, it says invalid age. Let us draw what happened over here to understand better. Pay attention, please. This is user. User saw the message. This is the message, everyone. Like that one. User saw the message. And then user gave me negative 3 as age. Can you see? This is negative 3. User gave me. And then next byte method took the value from the user and then assignment operator put the value into the age. So age container has 3. Negative 3 in it. Don't forget it. When you see age, it means it is negative 3 now. Okay, look at here. I will put negative 3. Negative 3 is less than 0. This is true. If it is true, that code will be executed. What is the code doing? It is printing invalid age. So over here, you are getting invalid age because of the if part. I told you in if, else if, else if, else if you find true ones, you don't read the next codes. Those codes will not be read, everyone. Just the first part was read by Java. Why Java doesn't check the others? First one, after finding true, no need to check the others. Second one, if you make Java work less, Java will be faster. Okay, Java will be faster. Is there any question about negative value scenarios? Now I will test the code by using another value. Run the code again. It says enter your age. I will enter 3, for example. Not negative 3, positive 3. I am pressing enter. It says baby. Let us check. I put 3 over here. I am checking the condition. 3 is less than 0. This condition is false. If it is false, that code will not be executed. As you see, Java couldn't find true in the first part, what will Java do? Java will come to the second condition. In the second condition, I will check it if it is true or false. 3 is less than or equal to 4. This is true, everyone. If it is true, that code will be executed. Because of that, you are getting baby over here. Java found true. After finding true, that code will not be read by Java. Java will skip those to make itself faster. This is the second scenario. Same thing will happen for 10, for example, for 18, for 25, for example. Let us test our code by using 45. Okay. When I enter 45, it will tell me not expected age. Let us see what will happen. The age is 45. This is 45. It says 45 is less than 0. It is false. Come over here. 45 is less than 4. It is false. 45 is less than 12. Again, false. Can you see? If you cannot find true, you should go on to read the codes. 45 is less than 20. It is false again. 45 is less than 30. It is false. Everyone, can you see? I am in the else part. In the else part, there is no any condition. Over here, no condition. If there is no condition, Java will check nothing. Java will execute that code directly. It is printing not expected age. Because of that, you will get that one. Okay. This is the extreme values. Pay attention, please. Everyone. When you type a code, you have to test the code definitely. Even it is very simple code, you have to test it. Actually, that task is very simple. Okay, that task is very simple. But we have to test it. Let us test it, everyone. I will draw a number line over here. And I will put critical values on the number line. What are the critical values? The numbers you used in your code, those are critical values. For example, I used 0. I have to put 0 on the number line. I used 4. Okay. This is critical value. 12, because before 12, I will do something. After 12, I will do another thing. Because of that, I am telling 12 is critical value. Okay. And then 20 is critical value. 30 is critical value. When you type the code, definitely you have to test your code by using critical values. It is must. Okay. And then, everyone, you have to take a value before every critical value. It is negative 3, for example. You have to use a value after the critical value. I used 3, maybe you remember. And then before critical value 4, I put 3. After critical value 4, I will put one more value, 5, for example. Can you see? Every critical value will have a test data before and after. 5 is before 12. So I will select after 12, for example, 13. It can be any value between that two. I am selecting 13. Before 20, I have 13. It is okay. Let us put one more, 25, for example. 25 is before 30, so I can select any other one, 45, for example. Can you see? This is very simple question, but I have to test it by using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 values. Because of that, testing in coding is very important. Okay. The name of that system to find test values is called boundary value analysis. Boundary value It has an abbreviation, BVA. You will learn those with details in SDLC course with Mr. Oğuzhan. But this is very simple. I wanted to teach you right now. Is there any question about boundary value analysis? Critical values. One value before every critical and one value after every critical. Without testing your code with that 11 values, don't tell to anyone I completed my task. Most probably it will create some issues. We don't want it. In coding, no need to rush, everyone. If you do a task fast, most probably it will have some issues, and then fixing the issues will take too much time. Don't think like that. There are 11 values, but I will test it just by using 5 of them. Don't do that one. Your code will give some errors. And then everyone will think like that. Oğuzhan finishes his tasks fast, but most of the times there are some errors on his codes. This is not good impact. Everyone should know you like that. Oğuzhan completes his task slowly, but it doesn't make any mistake. This is better than the other. Okay. The perfect one is do quickly and do quickly without any error. Okay. There is an adverb in IT area. They tell like that. Fast is slow. Slow is fast in IT. When you do fast, you will have errors on it. To fix it will take too much time. You will be slow. If you type your code slowly, if you spend more time on it, it will not have any error. You will not need to fix anything. It will be better. Okay? Fast is slow. Slow is fast. Actually, sometimes developers complete a task quickly and then they start to drink coffee at their home. They get rest. The problem is occurring from here. Otherwise, managers don't overload you. If you tell them, I have that task, I need time to complete it, managers will tell you it's okay. Because no manager wants any error on the application. It can be slow, no problem. But if you made error in the application, it is fire. We have a channel in our company. It is Slack channel. Its name is Daily Fire. If we get any message on Daily Fire channel, everyone checks it, if it is because of me or not. Okay. If it is because of you, it means everyone in the company will know Mr. Yusuf did a mistake. One of my friends was about crying. They scheduled a meeting. In the meeting, he told, nobody believes me. It is not because of me. I didn't touch to those codes. I don't know the reason of that fire. He was about to cry. Because last one who touched the code was he. Everyone thinks he is the responsible about the error. He was about to cry. Even he is a man. Normally, men don't cry, as you know. Okay. Okay, let us talk about a little bit more that quote. Everyone, what do you think? Can I change the places of the values? For example, I want to check to be less than 4 at the beginning, and then I will check to be less than 0. Let us do it. Less than 4, less than 0. Okay, let us make it like that. Less than 0. I will make that one baby. I will make that one invalid age. Okay. Can you see? The codes are same. I didn't change it. Just I made the first one to check less than 4. I made the second one to check less than 0. Let us test the code with negative values. Enter your age, negative 3. Can you see it tells baby? It is wrong. Normally, it should have told invalid age. Why I got that error? Look at here. If the age is negative 3, negative 3 is less than or equal to 4. This is true. If it is true, that code will be executed. Okay? You will have baby. But actually, it is not true. Why, everyone, am I getting that error? I changed the order. Yes. Order, everyone, order is very important for if, else if, else if, else if. If you have multiple conditions, you have to be careful about the order. Otherwise, you may get weird outputs. We don't want it. I am fixing my code. Negative 4, I will make it 0. Okay. This is baby. Okay. Now it will work correctly. Everyone, when you use if, else if, else if, you can go from left to right. It is possible. You can go from right to left. It is possible. But it depends on the requirements. For example, over here, I cannot start from 30 because negative 3 will be less than 30. It will give error again. But you have two options. You can go from left to right or from right to left. It is possible. Don't do that one. You started from 12 and then you switched to 30 and then you came to zero. Don't mix, everyone. Don't mix. Select an order according to the requirements. It can be from left to right or from right to left. Don't do those. Almost every time that one gives error. Okay. One more thing I will tell you. How many conditions are there over here? One is less than, the other one is equal to. Can you see? Java is checking two things over here, to be less than and to be equal to. There are two tasks for Java. It is not good. If you type your code like that, it will be slow. How can we fix it? Everyone, instead of using less than or equal to 12, you can type less than 13. That one and that one have same meaning. Okay. Both have same meaning. But over here, Java will check just one condition to be less than. It is better. Remove equals and make them 5. Equals 21. I mean, remove equals, make it 21. Remove equals, make it 31. Okay. That code will do the same. Is it clear, everyone? The last thing. Okay, Muhammed Irshad, when I tell you age is less than or equal to 4, which values are good for age, Muhammed? When you read that one, which values are good? Four is okay, because there is equality. Three is okay, it says less than. Two is okay, one is okay, those are. Okay, let us look at that one. I am typing age is less than 5. Which values are okay for age? I cannot use 5, there is no equality. I can use 4, 3, 2, 1. Can you see that two syntaxes are same? They have same meaning because you are getting same values. Which one is better to use? That one is better because over here there is just one thing to check, but over here there are two things to check. That one is preferable. Okay. I think that's enough for if else if to remember. Actually, Miss Sare solved questions in practice session, I think. I will. Share the code. Same question you solved. Oh my gosh. You should have told that one at the beginning, Mustafa. I could change the scenario. Yeah, it works as well. You can use and, it is possible, but this is better. Okay. Let us create one more, everyone. One more. Name it nested if statement. Nested if statement 01. This is the new class name. Again, I am creating main method inside the class. Okay. And we will do a task. This is your task. Copy and paste it over here. We will do it together. I will change the okay. Let me share the question like that. It will be more understandable. What is the meaning of nested? We have nested tables like that. The large one is having another table in it. This is nested table. I think everyone has nested table at home. This is nested table. If you put something into another thing, it is called nested in English. When I tell you nested if, I will put an if into another if. Okay. Inside the if, you will have another if. It is nested. Look at the task, everyone. Look at the task. At the beginning, I am checking to be uppercase. Can you see? Red one. It is checking to be uppercase. And then, if it is uppercase, I will check to be A over here. Can you see? Red one has one more if in it. If you draw it like that, that part is if, that part is if, that one is another if. Can you see blue one is inside the red one? Blue one is an if statement, red one is an if statement, blue is inside the red, because of that, that structure is nested if structure. Okay. This is nested if. Is it clear what the nested if is? Now we will type the code. It says ask user to enter a password. Because of that, I will type over here scanner. Okay. Input, new, and then constructor. Put semicolon. Inside the parentheses, I will put system.in. It's okay. And then I will give a message to the user. Enter password. Yes, Yusuf. Okay. As you know, passwords are having many different characters in it. It can have uppercase letters, lowercase letters, digits, symbols. Because of that, data type will be string. I am creating a string container. I will name it as PWD, stands for password, equals to, I will get input object and I will use next method, put semicolon. Because passwords don't use space character in it. Okay, everyone, when you use next method, you may use next line over here as well, Arife. I told you next line is for getting all words in a string. Next gets just first word from a string. We should ask it to Java, Semra, why didn't you create next string method? It is naming convention. Java named those like that. I don't know the reason. English people are telling refrigerator for buzdolabı. I am not criticizing English people. Why don't you tell buzdolabı? Why are you telling refrigerator? It is naming convention. Same in Java. Don't criticize Java. I like Java too much. And Java was created by many gifted people. Okay? Just try to understand. Don't start to criticize. Yeah, I defend Java, it is my love. Because I am earning money from Java. If something is beneficial for you, you will start to like it, Merve. I have an idiom. Learn Java, earn money. Can you see? Learn has earn in it. If you wanna earn, you have to learn. whatever you want, you can learn to earn. Okay, by typing that three lines, no pain, no gain, or no learn, no money. No Java, no money. Java equals to money. Java means money. Okay, let us come back to our task. Okay. Everyone, pay attention, please. User, this is our user. User gave us password, for example, A2! I am making it short. Everyone, when you use next method, it will take all, but the task is about the initial. I have to get initial, not all. I need that one, everyone. I need just the first character. I need initial. Why am I needing initial? Because the task is about initial. Can you see it says if the initial is uppercase, if the initial is A, if the initial is, that's it. Okay. Look at the second part. It says if the initial is lowercase, if the initial is Z, can you see? The thing I will check, initial. So I will get just the initial from the password. Let us try to do it. Everyone, to get initial, you will use char at method. Put dot after next, and then type over here char at zero. Okay. Char at zero. It will complain. It is very normal. We will fix it. No worries. Okay. What will char at do? Actually, method name is very clear. I am telling to Java, hey Java, I need character at zero. What is zero? Every string. Let me put one more question mark. One more, three, for example. This is my password. This is a string. This is a string. Every string has indexes. Indexes start from zero. It is general rule for indexes. If you look at the indexes behind the books, they start from zero. Every time indexes start from zero, because of that, when Java puts index for the characters, it starts from zero. So index of A is zero. Index of 2 is 1. Index of exclamation mark is 2. Index of question mark is 3. Index of 3 is 4. Those are the indexes. When I tell to Java, hey Java, I need character at zero. What does it mean? I will get the character at index zero. It will be A, okay? It will be first character. If you wanna get first character, you have to use zero every time. If you wanna get second character, that one, of course, you will use its index, which is one. If you put one over here, it will give you second character. If you wanna get third character, everyone, if you wanna get third character, you will put two over here. Could you notice the number of character is one more than the index? Compare those, everyone. Normally, this is third character. Exclamation mark is third character. Can you see index is 2, minus 1. If you subtract 1 from the index, you will have, sorry, from the order number, you will have the index. We will talk about that later. But for now, just I want you to understand too that Java uses indexes for string characters and it starts from 0. That's it. Why is it complaining? Let us look at it. Why is it complaining? Everyone, char at will give you a single character. In Java, single characters have char data type. Okay, char data type. Because of that, I have to change container to char. Can you see it fixed it? Let me put a note over here. Char at method returns just a single character. Okay, just a single character. Data type in Java for single characters is char. Okay. Because of that, I used char data type for the container, for the PVD container. Is that part clear, everyone? For everyone, we are 100. Okay. I told you, everyone, your names should be related with the content. If you tell password over here, it will not be true because from that code, I will not get password. I will get first character of the password. Because of that, I need to change the name of the variable to password initial. Okay, password initial. This is better for readability. When someone else read your code, he will understand that container will contain initial of the password. It is okay. If you put PWD, your code works, but it is not good for readability. Okay. That part was completed. Now, I will type my code. If, everyone, it says if the initial of password is uppercase A. Everyone, how can I check it? I will check it like that. Password initial is greater than or equal to A and password initial is less than or equal to Z. That one has a character in it. If the character is between uppercase A and uppercase Z, it means it is uppercase letter. Try to remember ASCII table. I told you upper cases start from A, ends at Z. Let us check it again to remember. Can you see? Upper cases are starting from A, ending at Z. If you are between that two, everyone, if you are between that two, you are definitely uppercase. Can you see A, B, C? All characters are uppercases. Because of that, I type the code like that. If my first character is between A and Z, it means that condition is true. Okay, that condition is true. And then what will I check? It says if it is A, make the output valid. If password initial, if password initial equals to A, I will type over here valid password. It says otherwise. Otherwise means else, everyone. Else, I will type over here invalid password. Can you see? I have large if and I have small if in it. Because of that, that code is called nested if statement. Can you see? This is the outer if. This is the outer if. And this is the inner if. It is like nested tables. Blue one is inner, red one is outer. Is it clear, everyone, that part? Do you have any question? Now we will type the second part. In the second part, it says if the initial of the password is lowercase, it should be Z. Okan asked a question. Okan says, why didn't I use equals method? Okan, equals method is just for strings. This is char, not string. Okay. And then I will type over here, else if it says if it is lowercase. How can I check to be lowercase? I will get my password initial and I will tell greater than or equal to lowercase a and less than or equal to lowercase z. Same logic. If you put the character between a and z, it means definitely it will be lowercase. It says if it is lowercase, check if it is Z or not. Again, if password initial equals to Z, and then I will print valid password. Otherwise, I will tell invalid password. Because if it is lowercase, definitely it should be Z. Otherwise, it says invalid over here. Okay. This is nested if. Let us test our code. At the beginning, I wanna put critical values. Critical value is uppercase A, uppercase Z. I used them in my code. Other critical values are lowercase A, lowercase Z. Those are critical values. Okay. I need to select a value between critical values. Let us make it K, for example. You can select any one of them. No need to select all. And over here, I will select L. L is looking like one. Let us select P over here. Okay. Before lowercase a, you can select any character by looking at the ASCII table. Could you please tell me a character before lowercase a and after lowercase z and before uppercase a? I need characters for that part, that part, that part. Could you please tell me by looking at the ASCII table? Should I wait or? It is for the, which one? Salık? Middle one or first one or third? For the first one, at. Okay. I will use that one. What about that one? Okay, division, that one, and I will put that one. I will test my codes with all of those characters. Let us test it. By everyone, pay attention. When I look at here, I am almost sure my code is perfect. Manager told me to complete that task in 2 hours. I completed it in 10 minutes. Working in IT is so easy. You will think like that. Let us test it. After testing, you will understand something better. Click on run button. Enter password. I wanna test at annotation. Because of that, at 1, 2, A, B, for example. This is my password. I am pressing enter. Can you see it didn't tell me anything? This is not good, everyone. An application should tell me something for every condition. But over here, I made the first character at, it is not telling me anything. Why? Because at is not uppercase. That part cannot work. At is not lowercase. That part doesn't work. What did I forget over here? I forgot else, everyone. For all the other characters, I mean, non-upper, non-lower ones, I should put over here a message. Can you see? When you test, you will understand your mistakes. Otherwise, you cannot. Okay, I will tell invalid password again. Because my password needs uppercase or lowercase. it doesn't accept the others, I am telling invalid password. Let us test the same again. 1, 2, AB, for example. Can you see it told me invalid? It's okay. By testing, I understood missing part. It is very important. Someone tells automation tester task will end after a couple of years. It is impossible, everyone. If anyone creates application, they need testers. Otherwise, applications will have many errors on them. Okay, let us test the code with A, clicking on run, A12BC, for example. Can you see I made the first character A, pressing enter. It says valid password, because when it is uppercase, it should be A, it is okay. Now, I am testing uppercase K. I put KTR12, for example. It says invalid password. What happened over here? Let us see it. As you see, initial is K. When you put over here uppercase K, it is greater than or equal to uppercase A. It is true. In ASCII table, uppercase K is coming after uppercase A. It is true. That one is true. Let us look at the second part. Uppercase K is less than or equal to uppercase Z. This is true as well, because K is before Z. This is true. When you use AND operation, if everything is true, the result will be true. Can you see? If outer if condition is true, what will Java do? Java will come to the inner if. Again, I will put over here uppercase K. It says equals to A. Everyone, K doesn't equal to A. It is false. If it is false, that code will not work. Else part has no any condition. It will work. You will see invalid password on the console. Because of that, you are getting that part. Is the flow clear for everyone? We will do one more example, Said, after the break. Now, I will test everyone. I will test that one. Lowercase a. Look at here, lowercase a. This is a. It says a is greater than uppercase a. This is true, everyone, because lowercase a has 97 as ASCII value, uppercase A has 65. 97 is not greater than, sorry, 97 is greater than 65. That part is true. Look at the that part. Uppercase A is less than, sorry, lowercase A is less than uppercase Z. This is false. Because the value of lowercase a is 97, uppercase z is 68, 67, something like that. It is false. In AND operation, when you get true false, it will be false. If the condition is false, that code will not be executed, everyone. That code will not be executed. What will Java do? Java is looking for true. It will come to the second part. Again, A is greater than or equal to A. This is true. A is less than or equal to Z. This is true. True and true will be true over here. If it is true, that part will be executed. I will put A over here. It says A equals to Z. This is false. If it is false, that code will not be executed. That one will be executed. You will see invalid password. This is the test flow for lowercase a. Okay. Let us give 10 minutes break time. After the break time, we will do one more example. One. And Mustafa says, why don't we look at just AZ? Mustafa, can you see when I test that one, I noticed my error over here. You should test with all the others. If you are asking me, can we do that question in another way? Of course, we can do it, Mustafa. Encoding a question can be solved in many ways, but over here, I wanna teach you nested if, because of it, I used that way. I will share all the codes. There is a request to make the break time 15 minutes. Okay, just for today, I am giving you 15 minutes. Don't make it for every day. Be online after 15 minutes. Okay, everyone, break time is over. In the previous session, we learned nested if statement. I am repeating, a question can be solved in many ways. Over here, to learn nested if, we solved the question by using nested if. There was a question, why did we use zero over here? I will explain it again. When you create a string, like Tom, for example, every character in the string will have indexes. Indexes will start from zero. So index of T will be zero. Index of O will be one. Index of M will be two. Okay. In the question, I need first character. Can you see first character has index zero? Because of that, I used zero over here. If the question was about second character, to get second character, I would use one. But over here, I need zero to work with the first character. Okay. Everyone, in coding, nested things are not preferable. If it is not must, don't use nested if. When we learn other subjects, we will learn nested things as well. But using nested things is not preferable. Why? Because nested codes makes Java slower. Nested codes have time complexity. Because of that, we don't prefer to use nested things. But for some tasks, it is being must. Because of that, we are learning nested if, or we will learn nested ternary, nested loops. Okay. Okay. Okan, if you type 68, let us test it. Okan says, if we use numbers 68, can you see it says invalid password? Invalid password is coming from here. Because 6 is not uppercase, 6 is not lowercase, that part will be activated. Büşra, you may use nested if, I am not telling don't use, but it is not preferable. If you have any other way, try to solve your question without using nested if. Nested if makes Java slower. It has time complexity. Because of that, we don't prefer to use it. Okay. Please select the package. Select the package. And then click on right button of the mouse, new and Java class. Name it as ternary. Switch 01. Make the class name switch 01. Password initial, Ahmet, is just the name of the variable. Variable names depend on you, but there is a naming convention in Java. You should make the names related with the concept. Over here, I am getting first character of the password. Because of that, I made the name password initial. Okay. Semra. There are no many characters, Semra. Pay attention. User entered A12B as password. Okay. That part will get A12B from user. But when you use char at method, char at zero, it will give you just the first character. Char at zero will give you first character. Can you see it is a single character? Because of that, I made the data type char. At the beginning, you are getting all password. And then you are selecting the first character. When you use char at zero, you will have a single character in your hand. Because of that, I am using char as data type. Is this clear, Semra? Switch 01, press enter, okay. This is our class. I couldn't get what you mean, Ahmet. Okay. This is main method, public static void main. Switch will do the same with if else if. Okay. Mr. Mehmet can check your code, Ahmet Şevki. Switch statement does the same with if else if with if else if. It has just different syntax. Okay. Instead of if else if you want, you can use switch statement. Their functionality will be same. So why are we selecting switch to use? Because its syntax is more readable, more understandable. To type it is very easy. Okay, let us do a task. I will do the same task by using if, else if, and by using switch to see the difference between them. Okay, this is our task. Let me put that one outside the main method. Get the number of days from users, from user, and print the name of the day. For example, user will give one, I will print Sunday on the console. User will give two, I will print Monday on the console. Okay. In the first way, I will use if else. If else if. I will use that. If, oh, at the beginning, I will get data from user. Let us get data from user. Scanner, I will import it. I will name it as input equals to new scanner semicolon. I will type over here system.in. Okay. And then I will give a message to the user like enter day name, day number. Enter day number. Day numbers are integers. I can create integer container, but to save memory, byte is better. I will make byte. I will name the variable as day number equals to, by using input object, I will select next byte method. It is done. That part is clear, I think. We did it many times. Okay. After getting day number, I will tell to Java, hey Java, if day number equals to one, print Sunday. in the United States, first day is Sunday. I will type else if day number equals to 2, okay, I will print Monday. I am doing copy paste to make it faster. And then I will copy else if part. Do it, please. Then paste it over here. Copy that one, then paste it. Change the day number to 3, day name to Tuesday. And then copy the last else if, paste it. Change day number to 4, day name is Wednesday. And then day number is 5, day name is Thursday. Day number is 6, day name is Friday. The last one, day number is 7, day name is Saturday. Is it confusing you to do copy paste? If it is, I can type it manually. Let me share the code. Okay. What do you think? Is the code completed? Is everything okay over here? I have 7 days. I typed code for every day. Is this done or I should do something more? Yes, we need to add else part because this is user. User can enter 10 as day number. Because of that, I will type over here else invalid day number. Invalid day number. Okay. Let us test our code. To test my code, I will use all critical values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Those are critical values. Between the critical values, there is no any byte. Between 1 and 2, there is no any byte value. But before 1, there is byte value, for example, -3. After 7, there is byte value, for example, 9. So I will test my code by using that 9 values, 7 days and 2 invalid day numbers. Let us test it. It says enter day number. I will enter -3. It says invalid day number. Can you see my test passed with negative value? And then I will run my code again. I will enter 1. It says Sunday. It is okay. My test passed with 1. When you type code, you will check all one by one like that. And then run it again. Test your code with two. It says Monday. It is okay. Test your code with three. It says Tuesday. It is okay. With four, it is okay. With five, it is Thursday. With six, it is Friday. Seven, it is Saturday. And with nine, it says invalid day number. It's okay, everyone. Can you see? All scenarios passed. It is good. All scenarios passed. When you look at the code, everyone, it is so long. Can you see? It is so long. And it is very complicated to read. Over here, I am typing very simple code. Even it is simple, can you see? It is complicated. The code is complicated. Let us do the same task by using switch statement. Second way, switch statement. Mr. Mehmet, could you please check Fatih's error? Sefa? No, it is not impossible. It is possible. Why? Can you see? I am testing my code. They will give you a task. You will type the code in 1 hour, and then you will spend 4 hours to test. In 5 hours, you will complete a task. It will be like that. Because of that, to create an application takes 3 years, 4 years. Okay, switch statement, everyone. To create switch statement, you should type switch. Type it, please. And then, like in if statement, open close parenthesis, open curly brace, press enter. It is very similar with if syntax, just instead of if, you will type switch over here. Okay. And then, everyone, inside the parenthesis, you will put the variable name. Can you see over here? We are typing a condition. In if, we type condition. In switch, we put just the name of the variable, day number. That's it. No need to type equality, something like that. It is better. Funda nested if is different from if else if. We learned if else if, we learned nested if. They are different things. They do similar things, but they are different. After typing that one, you will type over here case one. Okay. After typing case one, put colon, press enter. And then I will tell to Java, hey Java, print Sunday. And then I will put over here break, semicolon. Type that one and then we will talk the meaning of that code. Type it, please. What is happening over here? I didn't complete switch, just I will explain that part. Everyone, if user gives day number one, what will Java do? Java will come to the case one. Because the day number is one, Java will come to the case one. Okay. Under the case one, there is a code. I am telling to Java, print Sunday. Because of that, Sunday will be printed on the console. And then I am telling to Java, break. What is the meaning of break? Break will take you to the outside of the switch over here. What does it mean? After printing Sunday, Java will not check other cases. Over here, I type just one. You will not see, but when I type, you will understand. The others will not be read. Okay. Let us type the case two. Type over here, case two, and then I will tell Monday. Okay. After Monday, I will tell break. Let us type all cases, everyone. Case three. I will tell Tuesday. After printing Tuesday, I will tell to Java, take me outside the switch by typing break. Okay. Case four, system out println Wednesday. Okay. And then break. Case five. System out println Thursday. And then break. Case six. System out println Friday. I forgot to use double quotes. And then break. Case seven. Saturday. And then break again. And default. Default is same with else in if statements, okay? In switch, we will use default for all the other scenarios. For one, it will print Sunday. For two, Monday. For different from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, it will use default part. In the default part, I will tell to Java, invalid day number. Okay. Invalid day number. Default is the last part, everyone. Because of that, no need to use break. If you use break, it works, no problem. But if something is not must, we don't type it. Okay. Let us test our code with 2, for example. User gave me 2 as day number. Pay attention, please. What will Java do? Java will come into the switch statement. It says case 1. Everyone, minus 2. It is not 1. So that code will not be printed. Java will come over here. My case is 2. That one tells case 2. So that code will be executed. You will see Monday on the console. Okay. You will see Monday on the console. After printing Monday, there is break over here. What will break do? Break will take you outside the switch over here. Okay. Can you see? After finding expected case, Java didn't read those. Java didn't read those. If you don't put break, Java will execute those codes as well. Okay. Let us test the code with an invalid value. For example, user entered 10. Okay. Java will check first case. It is 1, but mine is 10. So that one will not work. Come to the second case. Its case number is 2, but mine is 10. It will not be executed. Because of the same reason, third one will not be executed. Java will come to the next. It is 4 minus 10. It will not be executed. And then next case is 5. It will not be executed. The other one is 6, but mine is 10. No execution. For the last one, no execution because it is 7 minus 10. Everyone, in the default part, there is no any case number as you see. It is like else. It will be executed without checking anything, everyone. You will have invalid day number over here. Yes, yes, the values are important also. The values are important over here. It is not second, third. Okay, can you see this is more readable, everyone? Inside the parentheses, we didn't type any condition. This is the first benefit. When you use if, you should think about the condition. It will be equal to, or it will be less than, or it will be more than. No need to think them. Just put the variable name inside the parentheses. This is the first thing. Second thing, as you see, it is very readable. If the day number is 1, print the Sunday, then go outside the switch statement. Hüsne, you used 2 parentheses. Can you see? You should have just 1. You put 1 more over here. After that one, use just a single. Okay, let us test by executing the code. Enter day number. I will enter 3. Can you see I got 2 Tuesdays? Why? First one is coming from if else if. Second one is coming from switch. I told you they do the same. Run the code again. Let us put 10. It says invalid day number twice. First one is coming from if else if, second one is coming from switch statement. Let me share my code. Everyone should make the code running. Okay. Pay attention, please. In if else if, the order was being important, but in switch, order of the cases is not important. I will put that one before case one. Can you see? I put case two at the beginning. I put case one later. Let us run the code. Enter day number three. Can you see both are working, everyone? Changing the places of the cases is not important in switch. Okay. This is the first thing you should know. Which one is preferable? I told, if it is possible, use switch. Okay. Switch is better than if. It is more readable. It is easier to type. Okay. One more thing, everyone. No, Fatma, you should try to do both together. Type code and listen to me. I told you, after 2 weeks, you will learn how to listen while you type. Okay. You will get used to type while you listen. It needs time. Be patient for 2 weeks, but constantly you should type. If you are so behind, ask the codes from me. I can share them. But actually, I don't want to share codes every time because students are not typing, just waiting for my codes. It is not good. To learn code typing needs code typing. At the beginning, it will be difficult, but you should insist on it, like learning walking for a baby. You may ask help from technical support, Fatma. Send a message to them, they will help you. Salık, you need to type codes. Did you solve code problems from Java Question Bank, everyone? Are you solving them? Because we completed variables, we completed data types, wrapper classes, if statements. If you type them, your keyboarding will be faster. But this is the fifth day. No need to worry to do everything perfectly. It needs time, everyone. I am telling you, at least 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, your keyboarding will be faster. Actually, they shared, I think, Mustafa. I think my test questions are also accessible. Did you see test questions on your LMS? No. We completed it. For practice sessions, everyone, for practice sessions, we have For practice sessions, we have some questions to solve to you. Miss Sare knows them. Some of them are from the Java question book. Some of them are from another questions. We created a curriculum for Java practice sessions. But when you solve questions from Java question bank, if you couldn't some of them, you may ask Miss Sare to solve them in practice session. Yes, everyone, it is almost mandatory to have second screen. For now, I have four screens when I teach you. If you try to follow me just from a single screen, you will have many difficulties. You should have at least two screens. If you have any issue how to use two screens, you may contact with technical support team. Yes, most probably they put it in LMS Funda. Java book has two parts. Java book has two parts. First part is test questions. Second part is code questions. And you have Java slides as well. But we don't share them, Gülşen, on Slack. They should be just on LMS, okay? Don't share it with your friends because they have publishing rights. If they didn't put it on LMS, I will ask them after the live session to put them in LMS for test questions, okay? Okay, let us go back to the switch statement. Let us talk about the functionality of break keyword. Yasemin, answers are behind the book. Where is your breaks, Fatih? Copy my codes, please. I shared it. Copy switch part. Okay. Now we are starting to talk about the meaning of break keyword. I told you, break takes you outside the switch statement. We understood it. Now, I will remove break from here and see what will happen. Please delete break from here. Don't put break after case one. Delete it. And then run the code again. Enter day number as 1. Put 1. Put 1. And then press enter. Can you see? It printed Sunday, Monday. What happened? Pay attention, please. Everyone, I put day number 1. Okay. Java came over here. This is 1. 1 is same with the 1. It's okay. It is printing Sunday. Because of that, you got Sunday over here. After printing Sunday, there is no break. Because of that, Java will execute the next code as well. You will see Monday. Can you see? If you don't put break after the cases, Java executes the next code automatically. If you wanna see Sunday, Monday together for 1, don't put break. But when you tell 1, if you wanna see just Sunday, you have to put break over here. Okay. Let us delete 1 more break. Okay. Arife, first one is coming from if statement. Just focus on last ones. Don't see first one. It is coming from if. Okay. Everyone, delete break after case 1, after case 2, and then run the code. And enter 1 again. What is your estimation? What will you see? For that code, when I enter 1, what will you see? Okay, let us test it. I am clicking on, pressing on enter. Don't look at the first Sunday, just focus on over here. Let us see what happened. User put 1 over here. Okay, so Java will come to the case 1, will print Sunday. Because of that, you are getting Sunday over here. After printing Sunday, there is no break. Java will print Monday. Because of that, you are seeing Monday. After printing Monday, there is no break. It will print Tuesday. It printed. But after printing Tuesday, there is break statement over here. It will take you outside the switch. When you go outside the switch, you will not see case 4, case 5, 6, 7, or default. None of them will be visible. Is it clear the functionality of break statement? I will put breaks again over here. Put the breaks. Okay. And then let me share that code with you. Yes, it is like stop execution. You are correct. Create a new class. Name it as switch02. Press enter. Put the main method inside the class. Today my internet is very slow. Actually, I sent the codes on Slack, but it is not. It is still processing. This is the task, everyone. If user enters 9, the code will print September, October, November, December. What does it mean? When I give you a month number, you will start to count month names from it to the December. Okay. Can you see 9 is September? It is counting to December. 5 is May. It is counting from May to the end, to December. I will not use if else. I will solve that question directly by using a switch statement. I will get the data from user, type the code to get data from user. Okay, it is done. And then give a message to the user, enter month number. Okay. Month number is integer, but byte is better to use to save memory. I will name it as month num equals to, by using input object, I will access to next byte method and use it. That's it. Okay. I will type switch. Okay. I will put month number inside the parentheses. And then I will type the cases. For the case 1, I will print January. Okay. What do you think? Should I use break after printing January or not? I shouldn't use break because after telling January, I have to tell February, March, April, according to the task. Can you see? In the previous task, I was needing to use break. Over here, I will not use break. It depends on the functionality. You will learn the meaning of every code, and then you will select the codes according to the functionality. For example, when you learn cooking, MasterChef will tell you, you will use that knife to cut bread. You will use that knife to cut fruit. You will use that spoon for that reason, that fork for that reason. MasterChef will teach you the functionality of every tool in the kitchen. And then after learning them, when you want to prepare a food, you will select appropriate tools. Same in coding, everyone. Now we are learning the meaning of switch, the meaning of break, the meaning of if, the meaning of nested if. We will learn them all one by one. And then when you need to do some tasks, you will select appropriate ones. Okay. After completing core Java, we will do a small, simple project with you about how to use those in a project. Yes, Funda, it's correct. Look at the example. When user tell file, it is printing the names from May to December. If the user tells 9, it is printing the month names from 9th one to the December. I will copy that one and then paste it over here, case 2 February. There is no January. What does it mean? January is the month name. I will put it over here. Okay, I will copy both of them. Do it, please. Copy both of them. And then paste it over here. Change the case number 3, 4. Okay. And then make it March, January, February, March, April. Okay. I will copy 4 of them. Do it, please. Copy 4 of them. Paste it over here. Change the case number to 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. After the April, you will use May as month name. And then June, July, August. June, July, August. Okay. I completed 8 months. Now I need 4 more. I will copy last 4, paste it over here. This is the 9, 10, 11, 12. After August, I should have September. October, November, and November, and December. Pay attention. After printing December, I have to put break. Why? If you don't put break after December, it will execute default part every time. But default part is for the values different from month numbers. Okay, I will tell invalid month number. Type the code like that, and then I will draw different scenarios. I can share the code. I will explain it, Gülşen, when I draw. Pay attention, please. What do you think? If user gives me 10, what should I see on the console? At the beginning, you should understand the question. Funda, I shared the code. You can do copy paste. Okay, when user enters 10, it will give you October, November, and December. This is the expected output. Let us check what will happen in the code. User gave 10 as month number. This is 1, it doesn't work. 2 will not work. 3, 4, 5, 6 will not work because mine is 10. 7 will not work. 8, 9 will not work. Java will come to the 10. Mine is 10. 10 will work. I will see October as I expected, everyone. As you see, after October, there is no break. So November will be executed automatically. I was needing it. After November, there is no break. December will be executed. This is December. Okay. After printing December, can you see there is break over here? Break will take me outside the switch. If you don't put break over here, Java will print that one as well. But for 10, I shouldn't see invalid month number because 10 is valid. Not to see that message for valid day month numbers, I put break over here. Is this clear why I put break after December? Gülşen, is it clear why I put break after December? Now I will explain why I didn't put breaks over here. Let us work with another scenario. I will run that code by using 10 to make sure if it is as expected or not. Can you see I'm putting 10? It printed October, November, December. I didn't see invalid month number over here. But if you delete, everyone, if you delete break, if you delete break, you will see invalid month number after 10. Can you see? It printed October, November, December. It printed that one. But for 10, to see that message is not true. Not to see that message, I have to put break over here. Now it will not visible. Thank you, Mevlüt. Mr. Mehmet, could you please check the screenshots? I cannot see. The internet is so slow today in my area. The images are taking time to be uploaded. Now, let us work with a different scenario. After May, please put break. After May, thank you, Seyda. After May, put break, please. Put break and then run the code. I will enter 2. Before pressing enter, let us see what will happen. This is user. User gave me 2. Okay. My expected output is February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November. This is my expected output. Let us see what will happen in the code. I put 2 over here. Case 1 will not be executed. Case 2 will be executed. I will see February on the console. It is expected. There is no break over here. It will print March. I was expecting to see March. It is okay. There is no break. I will see April. There is no break. I will see May. Over here, I will see May. It is okay. Can you see? If you put any break, Gülşen, if you put any break, it will take you outside the switch. You cannot see June, July, August on the console, but I need them. Can you see? In my task, I need to print those. But when you put any break, those will not be printed. Because of that, I didn't put any break for the first 12 cases. But after the 12th one, I put not to see a default message. That one. Okay. This is very important, everyone. They may ask you the meaning of break keyword in interviews. There is one more keyword, which is continue. We will learn it later. But break is used in switch statement to break the flow, to go outside the switch statement. I will share all the code. You can do copy paste. And then create a new class, please. Name it as switch 03. We have just 5 minutes. Yes, default has the same functionality with else in if statement. Okay, Rahima, I will type it. You do that one. Okay, we will create a simple calculator. Okay. Rahime, I am typing it over here as note after the switch. Not break keyword is used in switch statement to stop next case executions. Next case executions. Break keyword takes us to the outside the switch statement. Okay, that's it. Okay. Maybe I will take your 10 more minutes, everyone, to complete that task. I gave you 15 minutes break time because of a student. I couldn't remember her name. It was Asiye or Ayşe. Asiye, I think. Yes, it was Asiye. Okay. Because you will be patient. If you have any appointments, you can discuss the issue with Asiye. It is not because of me. I don't have any mistake about it. Asiye, protect yourself. Okay, I will get data from user. Scanner input, because if I don't solve that question, something will be unclear about switch statement. New scanner system that in did I share the task with you? Asiye, you confused me. I forgot what I did. Okay. System out println. Oh, I forgot to create main method. Create main method. Yes, Asiye. Can you see what happened to me? You shouldn't have changed the break time duration. All of my structure were broken. I had planned everything according to 10 minutes break time. When you change it 15, for the first time, it's okay, but don't do it again. Okay, enter the first number. Enter the first number. Because if you will do addition, you need at least two numbers. I am getting the first number from the user. I will make the number double to make operations better. Double, I will name it as first num, okay, first number. By using input and next double, I will get the value. And then copy that one, please. Paste it over here. Enter the second number. Okay. Change the variable name to second num. After typing first, copy and paste it, then change the first words to second. It's okay. Everyone, to do addition, you will need an operation sign. It will be plus sign or multiplication sign or subtraction sign. Because of that, I should ask user to enter operation sign. Enter the operation among plus, minus, multiplication, and division. User should select one of them. Okay, that's it. I will name the variable operation. Okay, but it should be everyone, that next, that char at zero. It should be char data type. Okay. Why did I use char at zero? Because this is just a single character, everyone. To get single character from user, you need to type that code every time. Is there any question about highlighted part? If you have, you may ask. I fixed myself. Okay, no question. I am proceeding. It is just, I put it, if you want, you can delete. It is not related with the code. It is the message. Okay. Okay. Fazilet, can you see those are single characters? Operation signs are single characters. This is subtraction, this is multiplication, this is division. To get single character from user, you need to type that code. There is no next char method. No, it is simple calculator. Mevlüt. But after the live session, if you want, you may add percentage sign, you may add square root, whichever you want, you may. But during the live session, doing that is enough. Zero is index, Rahime. Zero is index. Index zero means first character. Can you see over here, there is a single character. I will get it, first one. Okay, I am proceeding to the switch. I will tell to Java, switch operation. Because if the operation is addition, Java will do something. If the operation is subtraction, Java will do something. If the operation is multiplication, Java will do something. No break. In 10 minutes, I will end the question, Sefa. Okay. Everyone, case addition. This is char. Because of that, I have to put it between single quotes. And then I will tell first num plus second num. Okay. If it is plus sign, I should print the sum. Because of that, I put first number plus second number. In the other case, which is subtraction, case subtraction, put colon over here, and then system out println, first num minus second num. When it is subtraction, I am doing subtraction. Okay. Case three, so case multiplication, it is that one. If user selects that operation, I will print first num multiplication second num. Okay. In the last case, division I will print first num divided by second num. This is division operation. It's okay. If user selects different from those, I will tell to user that operation was not supported by this calculator. This is a message. Okay. What do you think? Did I do everything correct? Everyone, after printing addition, you shouldn't print subtraction. Because of that, you should put break over here. After doing subtraction, you shouldn't print multiplication. You have to put break. If user asks you to do multiplication, you shouldn't print division. Put break. After doing division, no need to tell that operation was not supported. Elvan, put break over here. Now everything is okay. Let me share the code. And then I will run it. Paste that one inside the main method. I am running the code. Enter the first number, 2. Enter the second number, 5. Enter the operation, plus sign, for example. Can you see it gave me 7? It is okay. It did the addition correctly. No problem. Let us test the multiplication. 2 is the first number. 5 is the second number. Operation is multiplication. Can you see it tells 10? Let us test the code, everyone. Enter the first number, 2. Enter the second number, 5. Enter the operation, question mark, for example. Can you see it says that operation was not supported by this calculator? Let me make it is not supported by this calculator. If you want, everyone, Mevlüt told me, let us add percentage as well. Okay. Oh, percentage is over here. I forgot it. Okay. Let us put percentage over here as well. Put case percentage. Okay. And then it will print. How can you calculate percentage? For example, 220%. You will calculate multiplication and then you will do divided by 100. This is the percentage. Let us test it. Enter the first number, 20, for example. Enter the second number, 5. I wanna calculate 5% of 20. Percentage sign, it is that one. Can you see it is 1. When you calculate 5% of 20, is it 1, everyone? Yes, 1. Okay. I will put that one among the messages as well. Can you see by using switch, we created a calculator in the 5th day, everyone. If you want, you may add more functionalities over here. You can improve your calculator. Is there any question about the codes in switch statement? Yeah, I forgot to put break. break over here as well. Not to see default message. Okay, tomorrow we have two more sessions. Until tomorrow, at the beginning, make all questions clear. I solved, and then look at the Java question book. It has switch statement questions. Try to solve them. If everyone, you have any question from the book, you may ask it to me related with the switch. Tomorrow, I will solve one or two questions about switch, and then we will start to learn ternary. Okay. If you have enough time, I will show you how to do self-study. First thing, everyone. First thing. Today, I created a class and solved a question in it. That question. When you do review, you will create a new class. You will name it as if statement 01 review. Okay. For the class I created during the live session, you create a review class. This is review class. Put main method in it. Okay. And then come to the class. Copy that code. This is the task. Paste it over here and try to solve it by yourself without looking at the solution. Okay. Try to solve it. You shouldn't look at that one. You shouldn't look at the solution. If you can solve that question without looking at my solution, it means it is okay. This is the first thing for you to do. Every question I solved in live session should be solved by yourself without looking at any solution. This is the first thing. After doing those, switch to the Java question bank. Solve the questions over there. Okay. And I will share the test book with you. You should solve all test questions as well. Everyone, test questions are for understanding the subject. Okay. Question books are doing for practices. Is this clear? How to do self-study? Okay. For every class I created, you should have a review class. It is must. Okay. Of course, we have Java slides as well. If you wanna review the subject from the slides, you can use them. If any part you couldn't understand during the live session, of course, you should rewatch the recording. It is must. I told you, everyone, I told you during the boot camp, you will eat, drink, and study. Stop walking around. Stop watching episodes. Just study. Okay? It is just 6 months. After 6 months, you will be rich. It is short time to be rich. Okay, see you everyone.